Hello, my brothers and sisters on the Dragon's Path. My name is Tim Heijen, and I believe in dragons. And welcome again in the Belgian Forest, where I came to live. I was not raised here, I just came to live here. And that is why, actually, I first of all, when I entered this forest, I first asked permission to enter this. Because, especially in the beginning, because the energy was so large, I could feel so much energy inside of this forest, that in the beginning I just said that if I can enter the forest. But now it's more like I blended inside of this forest. Every tree seems to know me in this forest, and I seem to know them. And together, the trees, the energy knows that I'm not going to harm anything of the forest, unlike some others that want to hurt the forest, but not me. I put a little bit more of fueled the fire of this forest, of the energy it already had. And the forest is alive, everything is alive. And so I asked permission to this forest to enter it, because it was already been inhabited by a lot of spirits. I just entered the dragon even more into this forest. So introduce this forest with dragon gates. So, and I want to say something different, actually, something about the dragon's path and the dragon spirituality. And that is not only that the guardian can be a shapeshifter, not only the dragon guards that can be a shapeshifter. Shapeshifting is an ability of all dragon spirits, which means that you can also do this. When I was a child, that is maybe strange. When I was a child, I already did this a bit. I was always saying that animals were worth more than we humans. I was always saying this. We are so much destroying so much. Even when I was just a small child, I'd already just judged everyone who wanted to harm the forest or harm other animals. I thought that animals were more than humans, always, and they even look a lot more beautiful than humans. That is what I said, and I already try to be something different, because I was never being proud of being a human being. Never. I already felt bad inside of my skin, not because of sexual thoughts. I don't care about that, but I just felt that I was actually having a wrong kind of body. And it felt like this. Even to this day, it seems like this body just doesn't seem with everything that is inside, the energy that I have. And even when I was a child, it was bothering me very, very much. And so I pretended sometimes, when no one was looking, to be a different kind of being, walking on all fours when no one was seeing it. Not really to play, but it was more shape-shifting, but not on the body. Your body, of course, cannot change shape, but your spirit can. Your soul is draconic. Whenever you are doing something like that, your soul will become that. Your soul will become that what you have in your mind when you are doing something like that. Because when I was doing this, I even, for moments that I thought I am this kind of particular animal that I had in mind. And sometimes it was a dragon, and that felt good. But the people said, oh, you shouldn't do that, because that is ridiculous. And yeah, the older that I got, the lesser that I did that. But I always felt something bad about this body that I had. It feels so not correct. Of course, people can say, oh, whatever, you are saying that you are some kind of a dragon. Well, no, you are a human. Yes, of course I am a human. I never said anything that I am a dragon or something like that. I am a human being. I cannot change that. But your soul, your spirit, your energy, it's more than that. And I discovered so many things. Things that were hidden. Things that were asleep. Things that I just pushed away for myself. And now I actually start to understand that it's more than a body, that it's more than just a human mind, that we are much more than that, and that we, just like a guardian and a god, have the ability to shapeshift. And just our soul, that our soul can do this, our spirit. I don't like to say soul, I just like more like to say energy. It's a dragon energy. Soul seems more like something religious, but it's a dragon energy that lives inside of you. And you, when you walk on all fours, that is why you can also become the dragon. You can also become the dragon because you are a shapeshifter and you can have the shape of a dragon. It doesn't even need to have the right shape of who you actually are as a dragon spirit. It can be every dragon that you have in your mind that you can take the form of inside of you. But you have to play along with this. It's not really playing. It's more like really, really intense magic. A dragon magic, because dragons are shapeshifters in their spirit, in their energy. And that is what you can also do. But you have to forget everything you know or think you know. Forget about humans that will judge you for this. I do not judge. I know what this is. And just walk on all fours and just imagine, not really imagine, but see and feel the teeth and the claw that you are not human inside 100%. That there is a dragon. Than a dragon that has already been living for a long time, but now is waking up, and that you have to help your own spirit and energy to wake up, and so that you can also be a shapeshifter inside of yourself. Shapeshifting is not really that difficult. It's inside of you, it's inside of your mind, it's who you are. Just follow your own mind in this, follow your what you actually want. And just forget what humans said. And you can also be a shapeshifter, just like your dragon gods and just like your dragon guardians. You are also a dragon spirit who can also be a shapeshifter. My brothers and sisters, be blessed.